I'm the professor of developmental psychology in society here at the University of Bristol. I'm interested in the way that we reason and how that changes from childhood up through to adulthood. I do a lot of public speaking, and last year I was the Royal Institution Christmas Lecturer. Well, the Christmas lectures are filmed in the Royal Institution in the original Faraday Theatre, which is actually the home of public engagement. And so I used to watch them as a kid as well, so I knew all about them. But what I didn't appreciate was the backstory to it and the amount of work and effort and preparation that goes into it. But public engagement can be a variety of activities. So you don't necessarily have to get up and give an hour's lecture or, you know, do something on television. It can be anything which really just tries to explain some of the things that we do.
So this is an event called Discover Science, and it's an opportunity for primary school children from all around the area to come in. We've got about 4,000 children in total coming, and they get to see exhibits put on by all different science departments. So I'm representing psychology, but we also have engineering, veterinary science, geology, loads of different sciences, and they get to come and do really hands-on activities, which they really enjoy. Bruce Hood is my PhD supervisor, and as well as helping me with all the academic side of my work, he's also really inspired me to get more involved in public engagement.
Well, to be honest, I was actually terrified, my first example of public engagement speaking, that I felt there was a need or a wanting to try and talk to the general public, to see it as applicable, because my research doesn't have obvious applications. And yet, I think the sort of the science behind it is inherently interesting. You know, how do children develop? What do they think? What explains the way they behave?
I worked with Bruce on the Christmas lectures, so developing demonstrations for interactive involvement with neuroscientific concepts for young children. I look specifically at how children learn between the ages of 2 and 6 and what misconceptions they come into learning environments with. So we're trying to discover what those misconceptions are and how you get over them so that you can actually start teaching children new information. It's brilliant working with kids. They come at it with very fresh eyes as well. So talking to them about why they think science is useful, I think all of that has real implications for how we understand our work and the research that we do as well.
I've been very fortunate to have assistants like Talia and Kate, who have relished the opportunity to do public engagement. It wasn't me forcing them into it. They naturally wanted to do that. And actually, you see that more and more with the students. I think they're starting to really enjoy this aspect.
So we won a grant from the Enterprise and Impact Development Fund, which is part of University of Bristol, to continue the demonstrations that we've developed for the Christmas lectures. We're actually evaluating which are the most effective and putting them together into a package, which is eventually going to be distributed across all the science museums in Britain.
I can see a real value of taking our research out to the community. Not only is it a mechanism for public engagement, but it allows us to evaluate the principles we've established in the lab to see if they really do apply out in the real world. And it's still important to try to inspire and trigger the imaginations of the next generation of scientists.